Hi folks, it's good to be with you today. I'm just going to read Galatians to you. Ephesians chapter 2, we'll read Ephesians chapter 2 in the Word of God. It says, "And you had him quickened, who were dead in trespass and sins, where in times past you walked according to the course of this world, and according to the prince of the power of the air, and the spirit that now worketh in the children of disobedience." The Bible says, it says, "And you had him quickened, who were dead in trespasses and sins." He says, "You who have quickened, who are dead in trespasses and sins." And if we don't know the Lord, if we don't know the Lord as our Savior, when we come to know Him, what happens is He awakens us. He opens our eyes. And He says that here. He says, "And you are the quickened who were dead in trespasses and sins." So when you walk past and you don't like preachers, you don't like the Word of God, the Bible calls you dead. The Bible says you're dead spiritually. But when God comes along, God quickens you, God awakens you. And God opens your heart, He opens your mind. And He begins to show you your own sin. He begins to show you what you really like. You remember that story, "Mirror, mirror on the wall, who's the fairest of them all?" And you look in the mirror, what do you see? When we look into the mirror of the Word of God, what do we see? We see that we're not what we think we are. We see that we're not quite what we think we are. "And you have He quickened, who were dead in trespass and sins, who in time past you walked according to the course of this world, according to the prince of the power of the air, the spirit that worketh in the children of disobedience." Why is it the nation doesn't want to know God? Why is it the nation doesn't want to know? The Bible says we are children of disobedience. We are children of disobedience. And what that means is we are going against what God says. God bless you, sir. You need Jesus. Thanks for your love, sir. Thanks for your love, mate. Thanks. "But God, among whom also we all had our conversations in time past, in the lust of the flesh, fulfilling the desires of the flesh and of the mind, and were by nature children of wrath." When we begin to go our own way, we fulfill the desires of the flesh. We fulfill the desires of the flesh. And the Bible says that we are children of wrath. That we are children of wrath. We like to know that God is like a fluffy Father Christmas God. That God is like a fluffy God. No, it says that we are the children of wrath. If we continue to rebel against God, then we become the children of wrath. Politicians who trample the Word of God become children of wrath. Anybody who rejects the Bible, tramples it down, and says, "I don't want to know," the Bible calls children of wrath. Political correctness will not get you into heaven. Scotland has become politically correct. The Church of Scotland has become politically correct. But you cannot get into heaven by political correctness. You get into heaven by Jesus Christ. Nicola Sturgeon cannot get you into heaven. She cannot get you into heaven with her political correctness. She will lead you to hell. But the Bible will lead you to heaven. The Bible will lead you to heaven. Jesus Christ is the King of Kings and Lord of Lords, and that is what Scotland needs. Scotland does not need political correctness. Scotland needs to get back to the Word of God. The schools and colleges and universities need to kick out political correctness and get back to the Bible. That's what we need today. Jesus said, I love wacky backy. No. He said, I love porn. He said, no. He said, Jesus said this. He said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. Wacky backy ain't the truth. Crack cocaine ain't the truth. Porn ain't the truth. Fiddling the gas and electric ain't the truth. Sex outside of marriage ain't the truth. Jesus is the truth. He says, I am the way, the truth, and the life. Jesus says, I am the way, the truth, and the life. Wacky backy ain't the truth. Crack cocaine ain't the truth. What is the truth? It's Jesus Christ. And he wants you to know his love today. He wants you to know his love today. It says, but God, who is rich in mercy, for his great love wherein he loved us. For God, who is rich in mercy. God is rich in mercy. God is rich in his mercy. When I survey the wondrous cross on which the Prince of Glory died, God is rich in mercy. You say, where's God in all the wars? Where's God in all the problems? God came down and died on a cross. Jesus Christ died on that cross and shed his blood for you. He shed his blood for you on that cross. He took your wrath. He took your punishment. He took your judgment upon himself. When I survey the wondrous cross on which the Prince of Glory died. You can have your pension, you can have your drugs, you can have your money, you can have your job, but it'll not get you anywhere as a nation. What will get you somewhere is Jesus Christ. That is what we need today. More of Christ. More of the Emmanuel, King of Kings and Lord of Lords. That's what we need today. Not postcards. Not even your weed and wacky-wacky everywhere. What we need is Christ. Christ in the home, Christ in the universities, Christ in the colleges. We need Christ, my friends. Christ died on that cross and he shed his blood and he is rich in mercy. God is rich in mercy. And if you want to be forgiven, if you want to be forgiven of any wrong that you've done, if you want to be forgiven of any wrong that you have done, God is rich in mercy. The Bible says in the Ten Commandments, thou shalt have no other gods before me. What have we made an idol in our lives?
I'm on the phone.
It says, thou shalt not steal. Thou shalt not steal. Have you stolen from your workplace? Have you stolen from college or university? Have you stolen from the tax man? Thou shalt not steal. Give the money back to the tax man, and whatever you've stolen, don't steal no more. But he died for your stealing. When he was on that cross, God was rich in mercy. When he shed his blood for you on that cross, Emmanuel poured out his blood. He poured out his blood on that cross. When I survey the wondrous cross on which the Prince of Glory died, Son of God shed his blood and he took the wrath. the wrath of God fell upon him. When he said, my God, why have you forsaken me? The wrath of God poured out on Jesus. The wrath of God was poured out on Jesus for your sin and my sin. For the things that you did wrong and I did wrong, he shed his blood and hung on that cross and shed his blood for you and for me. Behold, the Lamb of God that takes away the sin of the world. Behold him. And when he died on that cross, he was taking your wrath and your punishment. He was taking your judgment for you. He was taking your wrath on that cross. And he suffered and he said, my God, why have you forsaken me? And he shed his blood for you. Now the Bible says, there'll be weeping and gnashing of teeth. The Bible warns of a hell. The Bible warns of an eternal wrath and an eternal hell. The Bible warns of a hell of fire. The Bible warns of a hell of judgment. A weeping and gnashing of teeth and an eternal torment. That's what the Bible warns. But the Bible also says that Jesus died to save us. He died to save us. He died. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son. That whoever believes on him. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whoever believes on him shall not perish but have eternal life. My friend, one day I know one thing about your life. Even if I've never met you, I know one thing about you. You're going to die. One day you're going to die. And when you die, it's not the end when you go in the ground. You will rise to meet your Maker. And when you meet your Maker, he is going to be a judge. And he will judge you. And he will say to you, did you believe on my Son? Did you believe on my Son who came and died for you? And if you say, no, I didn't believe in him, I believed in political correctness, I believed in postmodernism, I believe in myself, I believe in my religion, I believe in this, I believe in that. But if you cannot say, I believe in Jesus, that he is my Lord, that he shed his blood for me and rose again, that he's my Savior, that he's my Lord, I don't say that, you're going to be lost. That's what the Bible says. Scotland and Paisley, you may laugh and you may mock. And you may think this is crazy, but one day you will die. When you die, this will be life to you. When you remember this day. Because I'm telling you, you will rise to hell or you'll rise to heaven. You will rise to glory or you'll rise to hell. There is only two ways to go. And political correctness and all the nonsense that is pumping out in Scotland today and pumping out in the UK. Political correctness will not save you. What will save you is Jesus Christ. That is who we need today. That is what we need today. Even when we were dead in sins, hath quickened us together with Christ. By grace you are saved. By grace you are saved. By grace you are saved. You're not saved by what you can do. You cannot earn your way to heaven. religion and man's ideas is that you earn your way to heaven. You cannot earn your way to heaven. It is by grace. Grace means undeserved mercy. That's what grace is. Grace is undeserved mercy. When God pours out His undeserved mercy to us, when we don't deserve it. You don't deserve to be saved. I don't deserve to be saved. And that's what grace is. Grace is something that God gives us even when we don't deserve it. And His grace was shown on that cross. His grace was shown on that cross. Even when we were dead in sins, have quickened us together with Christ. By grace, you are saved. By grace, you are saved. Not by what you can do, but by what God has done for you. God came down and died for you on that cross. God shed His blood for you on that cross. And He laid down His life for you on that cross. By grace, you are saved. You cannot earn it by your own ability. You cannot earn it by what you can do. It is all what God has done for you. By grace, you are saved. What you have to do is like a child. A child just sits in its father or mother's lap. Well, that's what it's like to be saved. It is to believe and rest in the promises of God like a little child. It is to rest in the promises of God like a little child. To rest in the promise of God that if you trust Him as your Lord and Savior, you will be saved. For by grace are you saved through faith. For by grace you are saved through faith. Faith is trusting God. Faith is trusting the Word of God. Faith is trusting Him that He will be there and not fail you. That is what faith is. Faith is trusting Him, trusting His Word. Trusting He cannot lie. Trusting He is faithful. That is what faith is. Faith is not blind. It's faith in a Savior where you can have evidences that He existed. But it is faith. Faith is resting in Jesus, believing in Jesus, trusting in Jesus, and knowing that Jesus will save you and change you and make you anew by faith. By grace are you saved through faith, and that not of yourself, it is a gift of God. God gives us the gift of faith. Even if you find it hard to believe, you say, yeah, I can't believe. I find it hard with all the wars and all that's going on. I find it hard to believe in Jesus. Ask God to give you faith. Ask God to give you faith. And He will give you the faith that you need. Ask Him. And He will give you the faith that you need. Then it says, for by grace are you saved through faith, not of yourselves, it is a gift of God, not of works, lest any man should boast. Not of works, lest any man should boast. Not of works, lest any man should boast. What he's saying here is you cannot get into heaven by good works, believe it or not. He said, not of works, lest any man should boast. You see, we all like to boast. We all like to be proud of what we do. We like to be proud of what we do. But you cannot get into the kingdom of heaven by pride. pride will not get you into the kingdom of heaven. You have to realize that your own good works, your own ability, cannot get you into heaven. Pride will keep you out of heaven. You have to humble yourself. And when you humble yourself, receive, like a little child, God's gift. You've got to receive, like a little child, God's gift. And that gift is His salvation. You receive it by faith as a little child. When you receive it by faith, you become saved. You become born again. You come to know the love of God in your life.
Amen.